eyeballs, limbs, and fake blood. It's not the set of a horror movie, and Damon Coyle is no prop master. But figuring out his actual job title, that's tricky.
I'm still trying to figure out that elevator pitch.
Damon is part engineer, part medical expert, and part artist. He works for the University of Missouri School of Medicine's Sheldon Clinical Simulation Center, creating task trainers. These lifelike models help students, doctors, and nurses practice essential skills.
There were a lot of products that were on the market that did not quite meet exactly what we wanted for the training purposes. And also costs continued to rise on those products. So it was a matter of trying to figure out how do we create a better product, but also reduce our cost.
When doctors and nurses in MU Healthcare's neonatal intensive care unit needed a more realistic trainer to practice placing IVs in tiny babies, Damon started with clay. He made a mold and then cast the model in platinum-cured silicone.
This is my favorite part.
Replicating every detail down to the baby's thin, translucent skin.
Look at all the colors in your hands. You have yellows, you have greens, you have reds. Those are things that we look at, but don't really pay much attention to, but an artist does.
Today, these trainers are used by both new and experienced nurses in the neonatal intensive care unit.
Oftentimes, you get a lot of practice throughout nursing school sticking on adults, which have a lot bigger veins. And then when you come to the nursery, the veins are very small. So it gives them the ability to practice the skills, feel confident in what they're doing.
Other creations range from a trainer for eye trauma to a bust that helps students identify signs of malnourishment.
The ultimate goal is to reduce negative patient outcomes, and I think that's what we're doing here.
Reducing the gap between training and real life. From the University of Missouri, I'm Teresa Snow.